The reason why it is so important to talk about capital expenditure at this point is because we're coming out of 15 years of overinvestment in several of the major industries in global economy, particularly in emerging markets, which means that in industries like resources, utilities, marine, and general industrial manufacturing, we see a lot less investment than we saw over the last few years. So as we look out to 2016, we see a drop in global capital expenditure by about 5%. And more importantly, we expect actually this decline in CapEx to continue until the end of the decade. One of the reasons why this downturn is perhaps different from others is basically the overcapacity issue. If you look at China, for example, and it's a very important one because it's one of the major sources of the growth in fixed investment globally. And now with growth slowing down, this is a very significant headwind to fight against. Apart from China has a driver of overcapacity, several of the global industries, such as mining, marine, or areas of oil and gas, also have overcapacity, which means the need to invest in long-life asset bases to cope with existing demand is not so big anymore. One of the most important impacts in terms of industry landscape that we see from this downturn in CapEx is that it will exacerbate what we have already started seeing, which is a shrinkage in the importance in fixed investment of old economies like manufacturing in favor of technology investment. And what this will mean for old economies is that not only you will have more price competition because you have more people chasing less demand, but it will also force companies to think where consolidation opportunities can be extracted to gain a share of this shrinking pie. And so as a consequence, we expect M&A within old economy industries to step up. There are clearly also important geographical implications of this. If we look back at the last 15 years when there was significant investment in CapEx in the world, a lot of that CapEx went into emerging market countries. And as such, the emerging market countries started to develop their own champions. And now with growth slowing down, those champions are ready to export. And so that will bring pressure specifically in the low-end equipment, in the more commoditized types of products in terms of pricing pressure globally, which will impact also developed market companies and force them to try to find new niches for innovation where they can differentiate from emerging market competitors. So as we enter this period of decline in CapEx that we expect for the rest of this decade, management teams will need to be a lot more focused in identifying what are their competitive advantages versus their peers, because they will need to grab share of a shrinking pie and they won't be able to benefit from growing demand for capital equipment like you had over the last 15 years.